Hello students, welcome to St. Joseph's Academy's online class. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing very well. Myself, Harshika Kain, your English teacher, and in today's class, we are going to study Chapter 1, Going to the Fair, Part 2. Of your English Mulberry book. My dear students, before we proceed further, let us have a quick recap of our previous class. In previous class, that is part 1 of this chapter, I had explained the chapter to you, and now I am going to give you a brief summary of the chapter. I told you that this chapter, Going to the Fair, is a small extract taken from the famous novel Charlotte Swab, written by a very famous writer named E.B. White. This chapter is focused on two children, Fern and her brother Avery, and their visit to a fair with their parents. The night before the fair, everybody went to bed early. Avery dreamt that the Ferris wheel had stopped and that he was in the top car. Fern dreamt that she was on the swings. Next day, when they visited the fair, they could hear the music and see the Ferris wheel turning in the sky. They could smell the dust and burgers frying. They could also see balloons aloft and could hear flocks of sheep bleating in their pens. Mrs. and Mr. Arable were unloading the animals for the show in the fair. Both the children asked for some pocket money to their parents as they wanted to enjoy there. Fern wanted to win a doll by spinning a wheel and buy a balloon. Avery wanted to steer a jet plane, buy frozen custard, a cheeseburger, and a balloon. Mrs. and Mr. Arable gave them some pocket money along with some instructions like don't eat a lot of stuff, hang tight on swings, don't get dirty and overheated, and to be beware of pickpockets. The children grabbed hands together and ran off to enjoy. Mrs. Arable was little worried about them, but Mr. Arable wanted them to see grow up, so he was not in tension, as according to him, the fair was a good place for it. Now let us begin with the exercises. We will start with the word meanings. First word, Ferris wheel. Ferris wheel means a large wheel ride at a fair which has seats on its edges for people to ride in. Like the night before the fair, everybody went to bed early and Avery dreamt that the Ferris wheel had stopped and he was in the top car. Second word, fairgrounds. Fairgrounds means fields or open areas where fairs are held. So, the next morning, they reached the fairgrounds or the place where fair was held. Third word, bleating. Bleating means crying sound of a sheep or goat. So when they reached the fairground next morning, they heard the sound of some music and also they heard flocks of sheep bleating in their pens. Fourth, overheated. Overheated means too hot. So Mrs. Arable, she gave some instructions to the children like don't get dirty and don't get overheated. Last word, pickpockets. Pickpockets means people who steal money from others' pockets. So Mr. Arable warned the children to watch out for pickpockets. Next exercise is making connections. In this first one is complete the following sentences. You have to complete the given sentences. The first one is every dreamed dash. So we all know that everyone goes to bed early the night before the fair, including the animals, dreaming of what they hope to experience. The night before the country fair, everyone goes to bed early to get enough rest, humans and animals alike, but find that their dreams are full of fantasies of the fair. And what did every dream? He dreamt that the Ferris wheel had stopped and that he was in the top car. So the answer to this sentence is, the complete sentence is, every dreamed that the Ferris wheel had stopped and he was in the top car. Second, Fawn dreamed dash. What did Fawn dream? She dreamt that she was on the swings. The answer is, Fawn dreamt that she was on the swings. Next exercise, draw up two lists, one showing how Fawn planned to spend her money and the other showing that every wanted to do with the money he had. So when next morning, when the family reached the fairground, they could see the Ferris wheel turning in the sky and they could hear some sound of music and some other sounds like flocks of sheep bleating in their pens. And after that, both the children, Fern and Avery, they demanded some pocket money from their parents. So what did they want to do with that money? You have to prepare two lists. One is Fern's list and another is Avery's list. And in those two lists, you have to write down what each child wanted to do with that money. So let us complete Fern's list first. What did Fern wanted to do? She wanted to win a doll by spinning a wheel and she wanted to buy a balloon. So what she wanted to do? She wanted to go on the swings. Second, she wanted to win a doll. And third, she wanted to buy a balloon. Now coming to Avery's list, what he wanted to do? He wanted to steer a jet plane. He wanted to buy frozen custard. He wanted to buy a cheeseburger and he wanted to buy a balloon. So first one is ride the Ferris wheel, steer a jet plane, eat a frozen custard and a cheeseburger, and last one is buy a balloon. Next exercise is reference to context. In this exercise, an extract from the chapter is given and related to that extract, few questions are given to which you have to answer. Let us read first extract, that is, you children be quiet till we get animals unloaded, said Mrs. Arable. Now the first question related to this extract is, who were the children that Mrs. Arable was speaking to? What were the names of the children? Mrs. and Mr. Arable, they have two children. The names of the children are Fern and Avery. So the answer to this first question is, Mrs. Arable was speaking to Avery and Fern. Second question, where were the Arables? Why were they there? So where they went? They went to a country fair. The Arables family was in the country fair. And why were they there? The children were there to enjoy themselves. And Mrs. and Mr. Arable went there with their animals so that they could participate in the animal show, which was going to happen in that fair that day. So the answer to this question is, the Arables were in the fair to see their animals? Third, why did Mrs. Arable ask the children to be quiet? So when the children demanded for some pocket money, she asked the children to be quiet. Why did she say so? Why did she ask her children to be quiet when they were asking for some pocket money? Because she was busy with unloading the animals from the truck in which they have brought them. The answer to this question is, she asked the children to be quiet because they were unloading the animals. Next extract is, watch out for pickpockets, warned their father. The first question is, why did Mr. and Mrs. Arable give instruction to their children? So, in the story we have studied that when Mr. Arable gave Fern and Avery some pocket money, he instructed them. He gave some instructions to them, like the money has to last all day. Don't spend it all in the first few minutes. Be back at the truck at noon time so that they all can have lunch together. Don't eat a lot of stuff that's going to make their stomach sick. And Mrs. Arable guided them that if they are going on swings, they have to hang on tight. Don't get dirty and don't get overheated. These were the instructions given by Mrs. Arable. Then Mr. Arable instructed them to watch out for pickpockets, means to beware of pickpockets. So why do you think these instructions were given to the children? Why? Because they wanted to make their children safe and responsible. The answer is, they gave instructions to their children to make them safe and responsible. Second question, list two other warnings that they gave to the children. So first warning is this, watch out for pickpockets, which is given in the extract. You have to list other two warnings. They got many instructions from their parents. Out of those, you have to list any two. So you can write down the instructions given by their mother. That is, don't get dirty, don't get overheated. The answer is, first one, don't get dirty. And second one, don't get overheated. These are the two warnings that they gave to the children. Third question, which word in the extract means people who steal purses and wallets? So from the given extract, that is, watch out for pickpockets, warned their father. In this extract, you have to find out a word which means same as people who steal purses and wallets. The answer is pickpockets. The answer, pickpockets. Pickpockets means people who steal purses and wallets, or we can say pickpockets are people who steal money from others' pockets. Next is read, reflect and write. This also contains few questions to which you have to answer. Let us begin with first question. What were the sounds that Fern and Avery heard when they reached the fair? So I told you that the next morning when they reached the fairgrounds, they could see the Ferris wheel turning in the sky and could hear the sound of some music. Along with that, they could smell the dust, they could smell burgers frying, they could see balloons aloft, and they could hear flocks of sheep bleating in their pens. So the two sounds which they have heard when they reach the fair are the sound of some music and the sound of the crying sound of sheep in their pens. The answer is, when they reached the fair, they heard the flock of sheep bleating and the wonderful music. Next question, how did the parents feel about the children going off on their own? How did the children feel about going off on their own? So this question contains two parts. First one, how did the parents feel about the children going off their own. When the children grabbed each other's hand and ran off in the direction of the swings, treats and rides. So how did the parents feel when they saw their children going off on their own? And second part is, how did the children feel about going off on their own? The answer to the first part is that when they saw the children going off on their own, Mrs. Arable was little worried about the children because she was worried that they might get lost in the crowd. She was worried whether they will be all right or not. But Mr. Arable, he answered her by making a statement that they have got to grow up sometime, because according to him, it was the best place where the children could learn the process of growing up or the responsibilities of growing up. And second part, how did the children feel about going off on their own? How they feel? They grabbed each other's hand and they ran off in the direction of the rides, towards the treats and to enjoy themselves. It means they were very happy because they were enjoying themselves. The answer is, Mrs. Arable was worried about children, but Mr. Arable wanted them to see grow up, so he was not in tension. The children felt merry and excited about going off on their own. Last question. Do you agree with Mr. Arable that the fair is a good place to start growing up? Write two reasons for your answer. So just now I told you that Mrs. Arable, she was quite worried about the children when she saw them going off on their own, because she was worried that they might get lost in the crowd. But Mr. Arable, he was not in tension and he answered her when she asked that whether it is all right to send the children off on alone in the crowd. He answered her by making a statement that they have got to grow up sometime. Why he made such a statement? Because according to him, the fair was the best place where the children could learn the process and responsibilities of growing up. So he was not in tension. The two reasons can be, he wanted to make the children responsible, and maybe according to him, the fair is a place, a good place, where they could learn the responsibilities of growing up, or how to use the money wisely or how to spend it wisely, because he instructed them that they don't have to spend all the money in the first few minutes and it has to last all day. The answer is, yes, I agree with Mr. Arable because it gives exposure to understand people and to use the money properly. So after explaining and discussing the word meanings and exercises, it's time for some homework now. Your homework is to complete all the word meanings and question answers in your mulberry copy. Also, you have to learn all the word meanings. So in homework, you complete all the word meanings and question answer in your English mulberry copy and learn all the word meanings given in this chapter. So students, with this, our today's class is over. I hope you all might have enjoyed the class and understood it very well. We will meet again soon in our next English class, where we will be studying part 3 of this chapter. In that part, we will be discussing the remaining exercises of this chapter. Till then, complete all your homework and stay safe. Thank you and have a nice day.